So today is the 35th lecture, and so it's good. Thank you for coming. And so we are still in, because Love's, I mean, Shell theory is a quite a involved derivation. It is not a, it cannot be finished in one day. So we are still continuing, but we have seen now, I have here summarized that you have to, because in order to transfer, I mean, your stress, and you should always say this and understand this philosophy very clearly, that you are trying to reduce the 3D problem to 3D elasticity to 2D shell. Shell is a 2D. So this is your aim, and for that you have to make some approximations, some assumptions. So in a displacement based, we assume some form of displacement field, that this is what is normally happens, and this is a linear variation of in plane displacement in the two directions. And we also assume that there is no change in transverse displacement through the thickness. These are very standard assumptions that we make right from beginning when we start developing beam theory. Okay. So this is the simplest that you will have to do, since here these terms are essential in shell, because if you have shell is, if the moment it is a curvature, if you apply, let us say you clamp this edge and leave this, so it is, I mean, it has to be stable, I mean, it is a structure. So and then you apply a tangential load here. So when you are applying a tangential load, it is not only undergoing membrane deformation, but also in the process bending. Similarly, if you apply only a pure bending at this edge, so this will not only bend, but it will also induce membrane forces in the, so here we cannot separate the two as it was in the case of flat. Flat we could solve the two problems separately, bending and membrane separately, only in isotropic case, or symmetrically laminated thicknesses where the mid surface coincided with centroid of the cross section, then only you can do that. But the moment it is non uniform, unsymmetrically laminated, then again the behavior is similar to plates, I am sorry, similar to shells, even in the case of plates. If you have a layered system where the material properties are not symmetrically placed with respect to mid surface, then the bending and membrane will be coupled, and that we have seen, I have also told you. So you have to start with this kind of displacement field. Even there, you also have to start with this kind of displacement field even in plates when the plate is subjected to thermal environment. You cannot avoid, thermal will always change. So this is what is important. So please understand, please understand the necessity, and the when we have to use this, when we have to use that model. So this is, now let us introduce, because yesterday I had given you a derivation of strain displacement relation where I said let us suspend this, and I showed you why suspend this, because if you suspend this, then M12 will not be equal to M21, N12 will not be equal to N21, which should be, actually curvatures are different, so it should be different. But then the moment you make this assumption, geometrical approximation, these become equal, and your sixth equilibrium equation is not identically satisfied. Yes. And so now we are introducing, so let that error be introduced, because after all it is a Love theory. So let us go by introduction of complete everything. Everything means shear strains are 0, normal strain, transverse normal strain is 0, and then this also including this one. So in that case, I have already put you in a outside a parenthesis, 1 by, I mean 1 divided by 1 plus z by r, r1 and r2 was there. So that will become 1, and you will get a simple relation like this, a simple relation like this, without any, does it contain any r? Yes, here it is coming r. Outside, you know, yesterday we had found it, it was outside, there was 1 plus, is it there or not? You have located that, what is difference between that relation and this relation that I have written? Whole thing multiplied by, I think it was 1 upon 1 plus z by r1. So that is now equal to 1, so we have just taken. So this is equal to this. And then gamma will be this, which I told you yesterday. That is theta, that is theta, not beta, theta. And of course these three strains are 0. And because you have put this, so it has given me one condition that theta and theta 2 can be found out in terms of u and w of the mid plane. So this is the rotations of the transverse normal about 2. 2 is okay. Now this morning I have written here minus 1. It is minus 1 direction. Yes, yes. So minus 1 direction. So it is not a vector rotation. If you want vector rotation, then you please change this model. If you are see, if you want to use finite elements, then it is better to keep everything positive in positive coordinate direction, so that when you join two elements, then it will be same sign convention will be followed. Without this one is the continuum sign convention. You know, I am developing a theory in continuum for single element, for single complete one, no question of, you know, making it small, you know, parts. So in that case, theta 2 here it will be minus. You can keep, or you can call it phi 1 and phi 2 with a minus sign. Rotations of normal about one axis and rotation of normal about two axis, positive two axis, provided you make this, you put a minus sign here. Now I have found out in some books they have written this minus, this plus. I do not understand. Anti-clockwise, not in, but what is anti-clockwise? But in a three dimension you have to have, but you have to have a coordinate axis. But anti-clockwise and clockwise in a three dimensional, it becomes very difficult to define. No. In plane it is okay. In a planar problem, as long as plane frame is concerned, one plane is concerned, it is okay, clockwise, anti-clock. Otherwise, best thing is to talk about axis, positive x axis, positive z axis. If it is x and y, z is this way. So my rotations in x y plane are such that they are positive in z direction. That is a very standard and safe sign convention, rather than saying no, anti-clockwise positive, anti-clockwise, then that will be coming outward, and x and y you have shown this, z is, but anyway plane it will work, but in three dimension it will become difficult. So what I am saying, be consistent and think about it, don't copy. Because when I was in UK, so finite element programming, the first book on finite element programming with Fortran program came Academic Press in I think 1978, and the authors are Hinton and Owen. So I will prefer, it is this is positive and this is negative, so that there is no, it is x y z then, 1 2 3 directions. So okay, so this is, then So, these are the three relations, this is there and this is there. Now, above it is convenient to write these three equations in this form. This form is very compact, and in plates also we write down in a way. I think I have given you strain equal to z times kappa 1 or kappa x, didn't I say that? Then epsilon y equal to z times kappa y there. Now, instead of just kappa x and kappa y, you will have kappa 1 and kappa 2, plus because of this in plane term, you will have this. So, this one, so these are all these terms are defined on the mid plane. What is beauty of this? This is 3 dimension, this is at x, y 1, 2 and point P. This refers to point P. All these quantities on the left hand side refers to point P. All these quantities on the right hand side refer to point P naught. P naught means it is on the surface, 2 dimensional quantities. So, these are 3 dimensional and this is 2 dimensional. Only thing, I will have to define these in terms of mid plane displacement. So, this is where I left. So, now I will be making use of extensive use of Krauss book. See, for me Krauss book is the best as of today. Okay, now you can have your own, but I find Krauss book is much more systematic and written. I am not using the notations that have been used by Krauss, you know, identically. So, slight difference is there, but the derivation, the chapter number 2, chapter 1, theory of surfaces, the chapter name itself is foundation, fundamental equations of, no, he says foundations of theory of thin shells. So, this is the basic. This is from where you build your foundation. So, this is, so here, okay. So, epsilon 1 0 on the right hand side there is a term. So, where, so whatever I showed you here, this one. Now, I will define all these 6 terms, 1 2 3 1 2 3. So, these 6 terms are epsilon 1 0 is 1 by A 1. Del u 1 by del alpha 1 plus u 2 by u 1 0 u 2 0 as per our sign convention, then this is this. I am not using superscript, I am using 0 on the same line as subscript. kappa 1 these ones are called, this is normal strain term corresponding to mid surface, normal strain in one direction, this is a normal strain. You know, strain means stretching, strain of, because it is only mid surface. So, this is a normal strain and then this is the shear strain in the plane 1, 2 means mid surface, and these are the curvatures of the two normal, and this is twisting curvature. It is called twisting, kappa 1 2 is twisting curvature, and this is A 2 by A 1. All the 6 terms are defined. Normal strain of the mid surface, shear strain of the mid surface, normal curvatures of the mid surface, and then this is the twisting curvature of the mid surface. And here these are called twisting curvature. See, there must be already a curvature. So, it is the change from that to the after you have applied the load. What is the change in curvature? Original curvature, I mean final curvature minus original curvature. So, it can be proved that these are final and minus original. In plate what happens? Final curvature minus initial curvature is 0. So, it does not matter, we only say curvature, but that is also a change in curvature. Okay. So, this is yes. Twist torsion is defined in the limit, yes. So, this completes your strain displacement relation, and then yesterday I had started already how to define stress resultants, and I not only define, I also drew the diagram, I have shown all the stress resultants on an element. Stress resultants are nothing but integral of stresses through the thickness, and they are all confined on the mid surface. So, before you can start stress resultant define, you must fix your Hooke's law. So, you must fix your Hooke's law here. What is the material that you are using? And that one I have told you that in a like plate, here also we use a small element of shell, any layer, because shell has now number of layers, any layer in a state of plane stress, which may be correct, which is not correct, but generally we take plane stress condition. We can take it also plane strain. I told you that there is no reason why we should make sigma z equal to 0. sigma z can be eliminated from the first two equations. I have told you already. So, we can also use plane strain. So, at least one assumption will be yes. Why to make unnecessarily? Because you are still getting two dimensional Hooke's law. So, either Hooke's law is plane stress and I think if for a BTech boy it will be nice to compare the results by taking for some specific problem using plane stress and plane strain. What is the difference? We do not make a so plane stress you always take. So, plane stress will be sigma 1 E1, sorry, let us say isotropic only. So, 1 minus. So, this is plane, you can write it like this. No, sometimes in a stress strain matrix, we write like this sigma 1, sigma 2, tau 1, 2. Why I have done this is this. We take this outside, so it becomes 1 nu 0 nu 1 0 and here it becomes 0 0 e, sorry, no, e is gone, just 1 minus nu by 2. So, this one we call, if this is your stress vector, plane stress, three components only, this we can call E matrix, E square matrix, E capital E, not modulus of elasticity, capital E means this multiplied by E strain. This can also be written as E 1 minus nu divided by 1 minus nu square tensorial component, so that it is tensor. So, this is so that its strain also is a tensor. So, this is this, and if you want tensorial, then it will be how to write. If you want to write down here, so what difference will it make? Of course, this is only thing, this will not be there, 2 will not be there. So, it will be tensorial. So, if you give some t or superscript or subscript t, do not say tangent modulus, nothing, is a t, and then this is like this, you can do. So, you can devise. Okay, so this is plane stress, or similarly plane stress also, plane strain also can be used. You can also use plane strain, and I will prefer plane strain. So, there it will be, what is the coefficient that becomes plane strain? these two states in plane stress plane, this changes na. What is? But E star is what? One minus nu square. I don't want to have confusion, huh? Okay. Anyway, you can write the plane strain also. So plane strain. What is the? I think anybody can. For example, the first one. Minus nu sigma 3, and sigma 3 is equal to what? Nu sigma 3. What is sigma 3 is equal to? So this one is sigma square, nu square sigma 1 plus sigma 2. So this we should remember, by E also is there. So this is the additional. So what is, I mean, if you forget the coefficient, so don't be under confusion. You simply write, yes, the last equation gives me that sigma 3 is equal to sigma 1 nu times sigma 1 plus sigma 2. So I am eliminating, and therefore now my coefficients are 1 minus nu square by E, and that becomes sigma 1, sorry, yes, that becomes sigma 1, and sigma 2, what it becomes? Sigma 1 is okay coefficient, and what is sigma 2? Sigma 2 is minus nu plus nu square by E, nu plus nu square by E into sigma 2. So this is, so you should, so this is sigma 1 minus nu into 1 plus nu by E into sigma 2, similarly epsilon 2 will be equal to minus by E sigma 2 minus nu 1 plus nu. And then gamma 1 2, gamma 1 2 no problem, there is no problem. So yes, just inverse of this. And then you invert, and write down sigma 1, sigma 2, tau 1, 2. So better you use this, because here at least one assumption is less. Okay. Before I go further, Krauss book is, I mean, it has beaten all the books. Timoshenko is no good when it comes to general theory. There are mistakes also, but it is a classic, first English book in English language. But I do not know how come French were ahead of English, I mean Americans, and they were teaching all these courses even before Britishers and Americans started. French university is older than all the rest of the world, you know, French. So the French books are older, and they had books in on shells and plates and all these elasticity much earlier than English. So but then I don't know why they were not translated, because the first book it is record, you know, first book English language is Timoshenko. no book came before Timoshenko in English language, and that too in 1934, in fact later, 34 is the first edition in written in Soviet Union. So, when he migrated to Turkey, then only he started translating it into English, he himself. So, that way. And the other people who have done, who are very good, is the Soviet, all Soviet Union, very extremely good. The amount of literature that is available on this subject is enormous. Before I go further, because I told you, I brought one more, and maybe Amit, you will be happy. You might have seen, but then. So he has written a very brief introduction. He is a classical analytical person to the theory of cells. You should say cells, C. L. Dime, Clive L. Dime, and this was published by Pergamon Press. See, I was the only one interested in cells. So, in most of the books you will find my name. Whoever has ordered, library writes the name of person. So, in most of the reports, cells, you will find my name, they will write. So, this book also was ordered by me. So, because unless a person is interested, it will not come to the library. So, this is also, I think at least library books should come, irrespective of whether you are teaching that subject or not. If there is a good book by somebody, it should be in our library. So, this is Oxford. So, I used to recommend lot of books to library in early years, first edition 1974. So, this I found out in 74, this book, it is a very 156 pages, it is class note. I think he must be giving this 56 pages including appendix, something he has derived, appendix, axis symmetry, yes. So, it just covers construction of first chapter. Again, he has followed similar approach of Krauss, no change. So, in fact, I find that he has copied Krauss. No, copied in the sense, almost when you start reading this, you find you are reading Krauss, you know, same type of presentation. Maybe if somebody reads my notes, they will also find that it is similar to Krauss. So, that could be. So, there are very few chapters here, theory of surfaces, construction of a shell theory, that means Love shell theory. Then fourth chapter is membrane shells, fifth chapter is bending of circular cylinders, and sixth chapter is shells of revolution. It is a good combination, and seventh chapter is axisymmetric vibrations of circular cylinders. So, few things are there, but it is good, compact, and one can understand. It is not otherwise, there are many books on cells in our library, they are too mathematical, only Dr. Amit Das can follow. Okay, they are all in tensorial notation, IJK, this one, that one. So, I find it very difficult. So, because tensor notation people have used in this too much, and ultimately when you are going to solve the problem, you have to expand IJK, it cannot, you cannot work in, only thing it sometimes helps only in constructing the do loops I j, you know, yes, but otherwise you will have to expand whole thing, then only you can write your program, Fortran program or MATLAB program, whatever you want to write, you will have to expand the entire, then only you can write. So, it does not help much, except that you can write in a very compact notation, and so this one is a good compact book. If you can get it, please get it, because this is a time compact book, and on lines of Krauss. Okay, so this is then after defining your this one constitutive relation, you go to stress resultant. So yesterday we have already given what are the stress resultants. Now this also will not be there now. If you are using, this z by r 2, this is what I derived yesterday. But then if you are using love theory and geometrical assumption, then this is same as plate. You have to use this only. Why should you use this? This is already small compared to unity. So that is where is the real. So n 2 will become only sigma 2 dz, n 1 2 and the other ones are we cannot define q 1 and q 2, q 1 and q 2. So, I think I want to emphasize that q 1 and q 2 based on constitutive relation are not defined, yesterday also I forgot, are not defined in love theory. Are not defined the way, not defined in integral sense. What should I write? Not defined in as integral. I think that will make it clear. Not defined as integral. In love theory. You cannot define like this. That can be found out from. Okay, so this is once you have defined this, and then you please draw the, you draw the surface. You have drawn the surface, and I have told you that the forces are and the moment, I mean forces and the moment vectors are not in the same plane. They are changing from left to right and from bottom to top, or whatever you want to call it, in one direction as well as in two directions. Therefore, you have to be careful and you have to transform these properly. This I had already given you yesterday. I will only rewrite, and then the element equilibrium after defining this. Of a differential what is difference between element? When you draw an element, it is a small portion of the shell or a plate or a beam, delta x in beam you draw. When you show the state of stress at point x, in what form do you write? We always show sigma x on this side also and sigma x on this side also. Element, that is a point. I think this I explained last time, in the last class. Point, we are at a point. So, the tensile stress on this will be tensile on the negative also, so that equilibrium is maintained. But when you are writing the equilibrium of an element, the size becomes finite. You are going from point P to point Q, although length is delta x only. Even for a point, you always show, let me consider an element of size dx dy, you always say. But then here explicitly we are saying we are moving from point P to point Q, point P to point R on the other direction. So that my these faces, there is some change of stress value from this face to this face, from this face to this face, there will be some change that will be taking place as you are moving. So that is what is when we write down for writing down the equilibrium equation. Are taking the equilibrium. So, this differential is important, this one. And so, always please draw, once you have shown all your, so you will get, you draw your element and you start doing it, and then you get your equilibrium equation. So, equilibrium equations are 6. Now, they are not only 5, they are 6. No, 6 is liye, because the 6th one also is not identically satisfied. Equilibrium equation, the del, I have given you already, I have asked you to derive, I am not deriving. What is P1, small P1? Loading on the surface of the shell. In one direction, P1 is in, so total load, let P be there, and there let there be 3 components, P1, P2 and Pn, 3 components in 3 directions. So, this is first equation, second equilibrium equation, sum of all forces in direction 2 and sum of all forces in n direction, normal direction, gives you yes, a 1, a 2, q 1, yes, these are the three about the three axes. So, we get these six relations, six equations of equilibrium. This one also is about normal, moment about normal equilibrium, because this is not identically satisfied, not identically satisfied in Love theory. So, this is again a contradiction. Okay, so we stop here.